Hey guys, so you now know that event organizers all over the world are using QR codes to make their events better. And one of the main aims of any event organizer is to ensure security in their event. That is, they only want authorized entries in their event, and secondly, they want to track down duplicate and irrelevant entries. And for this, you do not need any expensive setup or an expensive hardware to track down irrelevant entries. You can simply take QR code based tickets and achieve what you want. Here, with this, firstly, you can only validate authorized entries. And secondly, you do not have to make your guests to wait in long queues just at the entry gate to enter the event. So here is how it works. First, you need to use an online application such as Ticket Generator and create secure event tickets. Second, you can either download these tickets in printable format or email it directly to your guest. Third, you can also validate these tickets using an application known as Ticket Validator. You can download this from Google Play or App Store. Here, the coordinators or the event organizers can validate tickets and track down duplicate, valid and invalid tickets. So, you can also track the attendance of your event through the Ticket Generator dashboard. This way, you can easily manage entry and also in an affordable way. So, you need to go on the online application Ticket Generator and sign up for an account. Here, you need to enter your first name, your email address, and create a password. Once you have filled all the details, click on Create Account. So, you will be landed on a page where you can create tickets. The first step is to create event. If you have already created an event, select the event from the drop-down box. In case you do not have any event, click on Create New Event. Here, you have to specify the details of your event. The first column is event name. Here, specify the event name. Then, specify the date and timing of your event. Next, specify the date from when you want to activate the tickets. That is, from when you want the tickets to be validated. Note that ticket activation time should be at least 5 minutes later than the current time and at least 5 minutes before the start of the event. Then specify the time zone. Next, specify the venue of your event. Once you specify all the details, click on Create. Your event will be created. The second step is to design and generate event tickets. Here you will see the details of events that you have already specified. Then you will see two options. The first one is to generate and download. Here you can generate tickets and download them in printable formats. The second option is generate and email. Here, once you design the tickets, which we'll explain in the steps to come, you can directly email them to your guest. You just have to enter the email address of the recipient and specify the number of tickets you want to send per email ID. Likewise, go on to specify all the email IDs and the number of tickets you want to send. Now, you can also specify the email subject, the email body, and you can also specify the email to which you want your attendees to reply to. Once you specify all these details, you can click on Send Sample to test the tickets, or you can simply click on Generate. Your tickets will be generated and emailed to the guest. Now, let's see how you can design and download the tickets. Here, click on Edit Background. Here, you can either upload a background image or change the background color. You can choose any of the colors. Then, you can also add a logo. Now, you can click on the Edit icon and add an event description. Note that this description would be same for all the tickets. Next, you can add variable information such as seat number, row number or auditorium number, and this information would be different for each ticket. For this, you need to upload the spreadsheet containing all the information. Now you will see the number of tickets specified would be equal to the number of rows in the spreadsheet. Once you have specified all the details, click on Preview. You will get the preview of your ticket. If everything looks fine, go ahead to generate the tickets. Here, click on generate tickets. Now you will see the number of tickets you have generated and also the credits available. Note that credits need to be bought and each credit helps you create one ticket. Now click on generate tickets. Note that the tickets will be emailed to you. You can check your email for the ticket. In the email, you will get a link. Once you click on the link, the batch of tickets will be downloaded in a zip folder. You can unzip the folder and see the tickets. You can also download the ticket events by going on the dashboard of Ticket Generator. That is, in addition to email, you can go to your dashboard and click on Manage Events. Here you can select the event for which you want to download the tickets for. You will be landed on a page where you can just click on the download icon to download the tickets. The third step is to validate the tickets. For this, you will need the Ticket Validator app. For this, you can either directly download it from Google Play or you can go to the Ticket Generator dashboard and click on Ticket Validator app. And here, you can email the app download link to your email address. Once you download the app, open the Ticket Validator app. Here, you'll have to log in using the same username and the password that you used for the Ticket Generator application. You can see how it works by going on the Test Tickets option of your dashboard. Here, you will see sample tickets of valid tickets, invalid tickets, duplicate tickets, and bowl out QR code. Open the Ticket Validator app and go to sample events to scan the sample tickets we were just talking about. Here, click on open scanner and go on to scan the first sample ticket. Once you scan the first ticket, a pop-up will come. It shows a valid ticket. Now let's go on to scan the next ticket, which is an invalid ticket. Once the scanner scans, the pop-up will appear showing that it's an invalid ticket. Likewise, let's go on scanning the next sample ticket, that is a duplicate ticket. Once you scan the QR code of this ticket, a window will pop up showing you two options. The first is grant exit for re-entry, while the second is mark as duplicate ticket. Say an attendee wants to leave an event for a certain reason and wants to come back to the event. Now, if you want to authorize the re-entry of that attendee, you can click on grant exit for re-entry. If you do not want to authorize the entry, you can simply choose the second option, that is mark as duplicate ticket. For demo purposes, let's click on grant exit for re-entry. Now, if you scan such a QR code again, it will show that it is a valid ticket. Now, let's go on to scan the next ticket. Now, say the ticket has been worn out due to some reason and the QR code on the ticket has been worn out. In this case, the scanner will not be able to scan the QR code. In such situation, you can mention the serial code that is written just below the QR code. The ticket status will be fetched. Now, say you want to designate coordinators for an event. For this, go to the Ticket Generator dashboard and click on Manage Events. Here, select the event for which you want to designate the coordinators for. Once you select the event, you will be landed on a page where you will be able to see the Add and Edit Coordinator option. Here, specify the email ID of the person you want to be the coordinator of this event. Similarly, you can add the email IDs of all the people you want to be designated as coordinators for this event. Once you specify the email IDs, click on Send Invite. They will receive an email on how to set up an account on the Ticket Validator app. Similarly, say you want to revoke the access of a coordinator of your event. For this, again, click on Manage Event and go to Add or Edit Coordinator. Once you click on this option, you will see a window pop up. Here, click on Advanced Settings. Here you will see the email IDs of all the people who have been granted access as a coordinator. Click on Revoke Access for the email ID you want to revoke the access for as a coordinator of the event. The next step is to track the attendance of your event. For this, go to the option of Manage Events in your Ticket Generator dashboard. Then select the event for which you want to track the analytics for. Once you select the event, you'll be landed on a page where you can see the option of View Analytics. Click on this option. You will see that the event status is green. If the status is green, that means that the event is active and is still going on. You can also see the percentage of people who attended the event. Similarly, you can see the attendance per time period. You can also see the number of tickets validated per coordinator. Then you can also see the number of used, new, expired and invalid tickets. Next, you can see the duplicate and re-entry allowed counts. Also, you can download all this data in a CSV file.
We hope you liked the video. So, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.